It's just kind of weird this morning. Good morning. Good morning. How bad would it be if we like all got in the middle or something? Norwegians, I don't know what to tell you. Anyway, well, good morning. On behalf of myself and Pastor Karen, welcome to Christ the King Sunday this morning. We'll sing some songs of the King today. The Messiah, the Christ, is hailed in music and in word today. Why? Why Christ the King Sunday? Why do we do this on the last Sunday of the church year? Next Sunday is the beginning of Advent, the first Sunday of the church year. Why Christ the King? Well, what does this mean? What is it for? Those are good Lutheran questions, and we'll look for some answers today. We'll try to answer those very Lutheran questions and sing praises at the very same time. I pray that you find ways to connect with the mission and ministry here at Our Savior's. Remember why we are here, to know Christ and to have others know him. So today we get to know Christ as King. We get to know him, and then we get to be together servants of that same King. That is an awesome reason to sing. So rise with me as we go into our opening song, Life Song. Let's continue. To acknowledge the reality of the King in our midst by confessing our sins and being reminded of how that King, our King Jesus, forgives us. So we are gathered in the name of the Father of glory, in the name of God, the Son, our Redeemer, in the name of the God, the Holy and life-giving Spirit. Amen. The Son of righteousness shall rise with shining beams of healing. Let us gather under the wings of God's mercy. Gracious God, we acknowledge that we are sinners, and we confess our sins, those known to us that burden our hearts, and those unknown to us but seen by you. We know that before you nothing remains hidden, and in you everything is revealed. Free us from the slavery of sin, liberate us from the bondage of guilt, and work in us that which is pleasing in your sight. For the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. With a heart full of mercy and compassion, God saves us and forgives our sins, all our sins. Christ, the dawn from on high, shines upon us, and by the light of the Holy Spirit, guides our feet into the way of peace. Amen. Please join with me in the prayer of the day. O God, our true life, to serve you is freedom, and to know you is unending joy. We worship you, we glorify you, we give thanks to you for your great glory. Abide with us, reign in us, and make this world into a fit habitation for your divine majesty, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Sunday, so things are moving in a slightly different pattern this morning. So now is the time for the children's sermon. So if I could get the youngest folks up for this children's sermon, we need to think a little bit and talk a little bit and wonder a little bit about king. A king. What's a king? Come on up. Come on up. Let's look for a king. Let's see what we can see. Let's discover what we can discover. Let's find what we can find. Let's think about what we can think about a king. It's a candle. Yep, there we go. All right. Oh, one more. There we go. All right. One more coming. Yes. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. All right. What do you know about kings? Have you ever, in person, real life, seen a king? You have? On TV? Cool. Okay. You ever, and you've seen a king in a book, probably, maybe pictures of a king. What are the kings usually are like dressed like in rags, right? No, the kings are in like really fancy clothes, maybe with a crown on their head. All right, so today is Christ the King Sunday, where we think about how Jesus is our king. So I wanted to show you kind of, if you were looking around for what Jesus might be as a king, I wanted to maybe, you know, I have a couple of hats in here. One of them, I'm going to try to find a crown so that when we're going to talk about Jesus as king today, or it's going to be songs about Jesus as king today, so that when you see or hear something about a king, you'll recognize it. So I'm going to help you by putting on a hat, by putting on a crown today. And so that way when you see it. What? They're laughing at me. Does this mean this isn't the crown? Oh, okay. Well, all right. Well, anyway, so there's going to be songs, and there's going to be words like reign and king and majesty and ruler. So all during church this morning, if you listen for all those different majesty, all those different kinds of words that are talking about Jesus, our king, so that maybe when you see one, then you'll recognize. So let me try this hat. This is my king's hat to help. No. They don't. You're right. They don't think so. This is my railroad guy hat, I guess. All right, here, hold that, would you? Okay. So anyway, in the lessons, there's going to be songs. There's going to be words about how Jesus is our ruler and how Jesus is our prince and how Jesus' love is how we know that God is our king, and then how we can be just like Jesus. So we can put on a crown, the crown of God's love, and this has got to be it because it's got gold on it, right? So this is this the crown?
No.
Hold that. And I'm all out of hats. Well, the thing is, the way Jesus is our king, it's not like a normal king with a crown and the fancy robes. And maybe you've seen the picture of a king sitting on a big fancy cushy chair, a big throne. Jesus, Christ is our king. His throne is the cross. And his crown was actually a crown of thorns. And his love, though, kings are supposed to show love and to show us how to love. And Jesus, as our king, gets to do that. So listen today in the songs and in the lessons for words like love and joy and strength and king and majesty. And just pay attention and look for those words, because that'll help us see how Jesus is our king. That'll help you see how Jesus really is our king, even if there is no crown in my bag and no crown to see. Jesus' love is the crown that we all get to see. So pay attention in the rest of church today and listen for kingly words. All right, let's pray. Can you repeat after me? Thank you, God, for being our king. Amen. Thanks for coming up. You sure this one's not the king? Oh, man.
Raise up a new and righteous shepherd who will rule and restore Judah. Woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the shepherds who shepherd my people. It is you who have scattered my flock and have driven them away, and you have not attended to them. So I will attend to you for your evil doings, says the Lord. Then I myself will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the lands where I have driven them, and I will bring them back to their fold, and they shall be fruitful and multiply. I will raise up shepherds over them who will shepherd them, and they shall not fear any longer or be dismayed, nor shall any be missing, says the Lord. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In the days Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety. And this is the name by which he will be called, the Lord is our righteousness. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God. In a lot of the newer translations of Scripture, prophecies are written in the form of verse, as if they were created as song, as if they were sung, perhaps, by the prophets the very first time. This first song is that kind of prophecy. Very old prophecy. Beginning our music today, ancient, a song that warns against letting political leaders be the source of our confidence, because they have always failed us, the song sings. They will fail us. They always have. Jeremiah sings, God is the source of any true hope, and God will always be the source of any true confidence. God has always wanted to be our shepherd king, the ruler of God's people. From the very beginnings, after the people left Egypt, left out of slavery, traveled through the desert for 40 years, God first invited them to be a people together under his leadership, under God's leadership, with Christ, God, as king. It's how he always wanted it to be. God has always wanted to be our shepherd king. Those images of that shepherding and that kind of gentle, nurturing, feeding leadership sings in the verses of Jeremiah's prophecy. God has always wanted to be the love truth, the real, fact-founded, clear view of reality truth, where there will never be fear, and there never will be anymore. There, with Christ as king, we will not be dismayed, the song sings. And leaders, whether they're winners or losers of a political contest, whether it's peaceful or violent, here or somewhere else, any who scatter, any who destroy the peace and the love and the joy of God's people, they will be attended to, the song sings. Jeremiah prophesies. They will face the attending of the Lord. And instead we are offered a song of the King that realizes and accepts and acknowledges Jesus, the Christ in human form, as the real and the only King. This is a song of the King. Crown him with many crowns. Verses we sing will be the first and the last, verses 1 and 5.
Thank you.
Luke chapter 1, 68 through 79. Please read responsively. The assembly's portion is in bold print. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You've raised us for mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of your life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
These songs are old. This next one is a praise song, an echo of a New Testament story, a New Testament song of Zechariah. And because even if we are not completely sure how this king stuff works, we have seen more than enough of Christ the King's loving grace, even just in the realm of creation, to know that our response needs to be praise. Like this song of Zechariah. Zechariah, maybe you remember, husband to Elizabeth, old people. He was of the priestly clan. It was part of his yearly responsibility to go to Jerusalem, to go into the temple, into the Holy of Holies, one time a year, minister to the Lord all by himself, back in the Holy of Holies. It was part of the Jewish ritual that happened once a year. The year that it fell to Zechariah to be the priest that did that, he encountered the angel Gabriel. Yeah, that Gabriel. Back in the Holy of Holies, who told him that even though he was old and his wife Elizabeth was old, they were going to have a son whose job was going to be the forerunner for the Messiah. And Zechariah did not. Either he didn't understand it or it was just too much for him, but he questioned Gabriel. And in response, was silenced. 9 months, he was silenced. 9 months and 8 days, he was silenced. Angel-induced muteness can be difficult to bear. But in the day when the naming of his son was to happen, and he made it clear that this son's name, even though it was beyond family tradition, that his son's name was to be John. Then, as the angel had promised, his voice was opened, and the first thing he did was to sing this song. Blessing the Lord for what was already happening in the womb of his cousin, Jesus, 3 months along. And what was about to happen in his own son, who would come to be known as John the Baptist. And how creation itself would sing to the reality of this Christ the King. What Christ does in creation, what Christ the King does in Jesus, what Christ the King does in the Holy Spirit, adds beyond measure to our need to be the ones who sing this song. And our next song, the song of praises. As Martin Luther reminds us when he explains in the small catechism what the first article of the creed, I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, what that really means. As Martin Luther explains that to know the creator is to know that our response to that creation needs to be thank, praise, serve, and obey him. This is most certainly true. What Christ does in creation, what Christ the King does in Jesus, what Christ the King does in the Holy Spirit adds together beyond measure to our need to be those who do that praising, and not just in the words of a song. For this one who is our health and who is our salvation, but in ways, in actions, in loving ways that share that health and salvation, that lifting and sustaining. Praise to the Lord the Almighty is a song of the King. Verses 1 and 2.
The second reading is a reading from Colossians chapter 1, verses 11 through 20. An early Christian hymn praises the mystery of the political, personal, and mystical Christ, the one who was present at creation and is eternally reigning with God. May you be made strong with all the strength that comes from his glorious power, and may you be prepared to endure everything with patience, while joyfully giving thanks to the Father, who has enabled you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has rescued us from the power of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him all things in heaven and on earth were created, things visible and invisible. Whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers, all things have been created through him and for him. He himself is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have the first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross. Word of God, word of life.
Our third song, the one we will sing, is a short form version of the one Duane just read for us. One of the first songs the followers of Jesus sang about Christ the King in the lands beyond where Jesus walked. Places where Paul started the churches. This song that described and connected Jesus, the Christ, with the beginnings of creation, with the all of creation, with the cosmos and the universe and every fiber of it. The King shares holy strength for endurance and for the patience of God's people. The early church knew it well. So they sang a song that connected our human faith endurance to the cosmic reality of Christ the King, reminding those early believers and us, as we hear it again and as we will sing in a moment, that we, our hope, our strength, our peace, our joy, our love, it doesn't come from inside us. It's not something that we conjure up on by our own effort. It's connected to the creative power of the universe. The same God that made the stars and the galaxies and that stretched out the heavens and went into an incredible and infinite detail on the insides of the with atoms and subatomic particles. That same God is where our love comes from. Our ability to love, our strength to love. The early church knew it well. So they sang this song that connected their faith to that cosmic reality of the Christ King. This Christ King rescued them, and they knew it. So they sang. When we sing, do we see, can we see how Christ the King is all of the universe from Big Bang to however it ends? Do we see how every atom and every galaxy, every nudge of gravity or every tweak of conscience is the Christ at work in the cosmos? Do we see Christ the King in everything? Do we see the King's throne that has taken on the odd cruciform shape of sacrifice? Do we see the peace that the debt this King has paid, has bought for us? Lord, I lift your name on high is a song of the King. The Gospel of Christ the King Sunday, I invite you to rise and prepare your hearts to hear the end of the story. Luke 23, beginning with verse 33. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with criminals, one on his right and one on his left. And then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And the soldiers cast lots to divide his clothing, and the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself, if he's the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There's also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah, the chosen one, the King? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds, but this one has done nothing wrong." And then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. So odd, so strange, so beautiful, this Christ King. Our psalm that Duane led us in this morning was from the beginning of the story. Jesus just still in Mary's womb, and yet already Zechariah could sing his song of understanding and of faith and of power. This one is going to do amazing things, is already doing amazing things, saving, forgiving. And here, the end of the story, from the end of Jesus' life, what it took to sing Zechariah's song. So odd, so strange, so beautiful, this Christ King. So odd because the world wants a king with political power. But the politicians of that day made sure this Christ King kept his promise to die. The world wants a king with influence. The military of that day made sure our Christ King was mocked. The world wants a king in robes and in fine appearance on a throne of glory. The religious forces of that day made sure our king was stripped and naked. The world wants a king to stand for law and order. Our king offered a rightly condemned man a place of forgiveness with him in paradise. The world wants a king with his hands on the tools of power and conquest. Our king suffered the impact of those weapons in his hands, in his feet, in his side. So odd, so strange, so beautiful, this Christ King. And yet it seems too many of us fail to embrace that true beauty of Christ the King, the beauty of sacrifice, the beauty of forgiveness, the beauty of peace, the beauty of giving, the beauty of real love. We seem unable to see the bright shine of Jesus, beyond that even of angels, that glows not from the halls of power but from the rough wood of Christ the King's true throne, the cross. Too odd for us, perhaps too strange for us, perhaps too beautiful, this Christ King. Maybe, perhaps, if we sing with open hearts this song of our King, perhaps if we walk in the cadence of its melody, if we act in the rhythm of its truth, if we love in the sparkling beauty of its fairness, our sorrowing spirits will sing indeed. Because beautiful Savior is the song of our King. Thank you.
confess our faith this day. I believe in
God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all. I invite you to share God's peace with your neighbors.
For all your offering of time, of energy, of prayer, and now of a little bit of your financial resources, your ministry staff is grateful. The world around us that is served because of you is grateful. Thank you. As we begin the process of gathering this morning's offering, thank you for all of your support. If you haven't had a chance to get your pledge cards in for next year's, for your plans for giving, those are available on the table where the offering envelopes are. If you haven't had a chance to pick up your offering envelopes, those are just in the entryway there. You can grab those on your way to coffee. A huge thank you, too, for the offering of this past week of a lot of energy, a lot of effort, a lot of recipes, a lot of donuts, a lot of krumkaka, a lot of rosettes. The lefse is gone. Anyway, the bazaar was a good success. The weather kind of gave us a little bit of a twinge there, but it was a great weekend. Sharon Putica and Judy. Judy Wiles were sort of the ramrods. A lot of you responded to their rodding and showed up and did some and a lot of work. So it was a great week and a great bazaar. There are a few leftovers. They are available in the fireside room this morning after service. There's a lot of rosettes available, a little bit of krumkaka, some gingerbread cookies, and some crafts there as well. So if you want to get some holiday baking goodies, there's still some available this morning. And they're all fantastic. Big thank you out to everyone who did that. Also coming up this week, the New Horizons Christian Preschool is sponsoring a ladies' night out on Tuesday night at 6 o'clock in our fellowship hall. There's the details going to be showing up for that are available in this morning's bulletin, but 6 o'clock on Tuesday night, a ladies' night out, and the proceeds help to support the work of our preschool. So be aware of that coming up today, this week as well. We're in the process of trying to figure out how bell ringing at Super One is going to work with Salvation Army. There's still a little bit of detail that needs to be worked out with that. So perhaps we'll be getting back to you shortly on how you might be able to help out with that ministry this year as well. So be aware and watching for that. In addition, would you rise with me as your gifts are presented and as we pray a prayer blessing upon those?
Let us pray. Merciful God, as grains of wheat scattered upon the hills were gathered together to become one bread, so let your church be gathered together from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. For yours is the glory through Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen. With the people of God gathered here and throughout the world, we offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation. For Christ's church on earth, and for those who proclaim the good news of your reign, that all divisions cease, let us pray. For your creation in all its beauty, for water and land and snow and plants and animals, and for those who advocate for the just use of the earth, that all creatures may enjoy life abundant, let us pray. For government leaders, for those who provide justice and safety, and for those in war-torn places, that all be guided by the peace of the Lord, let us pray. For the alienated, for the sick and suffering, for those living with HIV/AIDS, and for those in need of reconciliation, that God provide them with skilled medical practitioners and counselors, let us pray. For those traveling this week, for those gathered with family and friends, for protection from inclement weather. We pray for Christina and Laura and the youth from Our Saviors in Zion Lutheran Churches as they will be returning from the Synod Youth Gathering held in Brainerd. And we pray for the body of Christ gathered here. Let us pray. In thanksgiving for all the saints who live their lives giving thanks to God, and are now at rest, that their witness strengthen our confidence in the resurrection to eternal life, let us pray. Almighty God, you have promised to hear those who call upon your name. We commend all our unspoken and silent prayers to you, trusting in your abundant mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And let us join together in praying with confidence the prayer our Lord and Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. As we prepare to hear and remember the words of Jesus, our Lord, who gave us this Holy Supper, hear us, O Lord. In response to the call of God, the command of Jesus Christ, and the bond of our common faith, we come to the table. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." In response to the love of our Creator and remembering the death and resurrection of Jesus our Savior, we come to the table. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this to remember me." In the grapes, in the middle of the other patent, We have a reminder of God's love and forgiveness for the youngest of our assembly. As the grapes grow and are shaped into wine, so too our faith matures and shapes our lives. Following our Lord's command and responding to our need for forgiveness, we come. You may be seated and know that all are welcome.
Thank you.
Would you rise with me for the blessing? Christ the King, all the power of the universe, offered to us in the body and blood of Jesus. May that strength go with you this day, every day, as you serve, love, and hope in God's grace now and forever. Please pray with me. We give you thanks, shepherding God, that you have gathered your scattered flock again this day, feeding us richly with the food of paradise. Accompany us as we serve you all the days of our lives, and gather us with the saints in the day of our death, through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and Lord. Amen. There's no communion kit present for the home communions, so we'll go directly to today's blessing. May the God who loves us, who gives us eternal consolation and good hope, comfort your hearts and strengthen them in every good work and word. And the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you forever. Amen. My Redeemer lives.